the burnout, pussy. That shit was so ass. Oh my god.
What is up, guys? My phone died and my GoPro was charging and I forgot to record, but today we're slamming the GR86. I'm almost done. This is literally the last side I have to do. Yeah, it's a bit of a mess to do the rear because you gotta pull this back right there. Pull this back. This side's already done. Yes, I did go with RSR Super Down Springs. These are the stock fronts. I don't know where I put the stock rear, to be honest, but yeah, let me keep going so I can get better footage of the car after I lower it, because yeah, I kind of messed up and I got ahead of myself and my phone is dead and I didn't have my GoPro on me because it was charging. So I know I'm a bad vlogger, but we're about to lower the car. We're this close to being not slammed, but track spec. And for those of you wondering, yes, these are WRX wheels. They fit perfectly on this car. They're a little sunk in because, you know, 50 offset. Stocks are like 48, so not that much of a difference. But I did buy, I believe it's called a Noble 20 millimeter spacer or 15 millimeter spacer from Import Image Racing. That should get here tomorrow. I probably won't install it till later in that week, but for now the car is looking minty, very minty. Guys, so here she is in all her glory, super clean. She's dirty, but the car is nice, man. I really can't believe I own this car. The back, I wish the back would have dropped a little bit more. It might just look like that because of the offset of the wheels, the hovercraft fitment. But I feel like a 245 with the spacer, we'll definitely, you know, put that tire out of it. The front, should be fine with the spacer, but I'm getting 225s or 215s in the front just because I don't like the way the fitment is in the front at all. So, yeah. But so far, she looks amazing, especially this angle right here. The car looks really, really good in this angle.
Guys, so it's been about a week, 2 weeks since I lowered the GR86. She's looking minty. I did end up putting a spoiler on it, wing. Kind of looks like a super one, but it's not. I think it looks pretty clean. So today, to finish up this lowering install / brake upgrade, we're going to be putting the Beat Rush brake support. It goes something like this. I'll show you. You can kind of see, you gotta remove these guys and then this will just sit boom like that, and it'll just cause this not to flex as much, stiffening up your brakes, making it seem like you have a BBK, but you really don't. So yeah, let me install this and as soon as I get a chance we'll drive the car around so you can see how it brakes, how it stops. All right, so I was able to get it on. It's not really like a direct fit since they haven't made one that's for the Gen 2 chassis. This is all Gen 1 stuff that, you know, they have. But it does work, and it actually did make the brake pedal a little bit stiffer because there's not a lot of movement here. It's making it all, you know, given that it's just a support, it's like a shock absorber for your brake pedal, you know.
I'm gonna drive it around, see how, you know, how much stiffer the brakes are. The brakes do feel a bit squishy on this car. They're not as hard as you would expect for, you know, something that's meant to be a sports car to an extent, or track-oriented vehicle like the GR86. I know the BRZ is, you know, tuned to be more like a Grand Tourer, but I'm only going off based off, you know, the evidence that I have. But so far, everything looks good here. It's nice and tight. I didn't like the way this line was sitting, so I just put this on there so it's not rubbing up against it, because I don't want this to explode and I die, because this is for, I believe it's for like the ABS stuff. So yeah, I'm not trying to die. It is so loud, yet it sounds so good. That's the highest I normally shift my car to, and that's because I want to not blow it up. I want to keep this car running for a long time, you know, at least until the motor blows and I can slap a K24 in there or a 2JZ, whatever is cheaper at the time, you know, whatever I can do. Oh my gosh. It is not that bad. There's a strange wrap. Oh my god. I have a 14-mil socket here, and it's... it's digging into me. Okay, here we go. It's not that bad. Well, you guys are migrating a lot. Oh, that is not good. That's not a good camera. Well, we'll see in post. Oh, God. So this transmission is called the A960E, I believe this is what this car has. From what I've seen, looking underneath the car, there's really not a lot of info online on what transmission is in the automatic BRZs and GR86s. So that leads me to believe that they're still using the A960E from the Lexus IS250 and IS350 and the LS460 and 430 and SC430, like newer stuff. A lot of Lexus came with that A960E, okay? So that A960E is not a bad transmission. It's a 6-speed automatic. And that's what leads me to believe that this is a 6-speed automatic. And I think they've programmed it to shift a lot more aggressively than, oh my gosh, two cops. Which is what they both use, I believe. I know the FRS had it, and the 86 has had it. I don't know if this year does. It's programmed to shift like a DCT. It kind of does. It just feels like a newer version of Lexus's E-Shift. I feel like they just put newer electronics and the upgraded valve body. You know, like the newest version of the valve body for this specific transmission that's been around for, God, almost 20 years.
Hey, homie with the RSX, he's lit. I was trying to like do like a wheel with rev dump, but I realized I'm an automatic, so I can't do that. Dust got weird dual clutch shift. I don't know how they managed to do that. It's all in the programming, but see, it does that. It really does that. I mean, I don't know. Maybe I can increase the line pressure like you can do in the older Lexuses. I did it on my IS250, and it made the shifts a lot firmer. So, like, you know, maybe that'll work. Oh my god, more cops. What is going on? There's white cops everywhere today. Speak of the devil, there is an IS350 or 250 over there, and that one has the same transmission as this IS, the A960. I know the newer ones, like from 2016 and up or 2017 and up, they have the 8-speed automatic, which is almost like the same one that is in the ISF, the same thing that's in like the newer LS430s, which is a badass transmission, which is what they should have put in this, in my opinion, but it's a $30,000 car, you know? I can't be asking for too much. Then again, IS250s are $35,000, $40,000 cars, and they have the 8-speed. So why did Toyota not use the 8-speed on this? I think it sounds sick as hell. It sounds so sick. Oh, look, a Mustang. Ew, it's got sussy aero. Officially made it to the gym. I don't know if I'm gonna take you in, guys. I don't know if you guys are into fitness. I know some of my friends are, but I don't know if my viewers are. But mobbing in the GR86 is what I'm gonna call this video. Oh, I don't want to scrape. It's Audi people. What the heck? What the heck is the point? Oh, should I do a quick rep for the gram? I gotta chill.